Government expects to seize a record high, over 40 billion pesos worth of counterfeit goods this year. Andrea Taguines filed this report.
Philippine authorities are eyeing a more than 40 billion peso counterfeit haul this 2024, a record high amid intensified operations, especially during the holiday season. Since the start of the year, the National Committee on Intellectual Property Rights, or NCIPR, has seized more than 35 billion pesos worth of fake products, the bulk of which were intercepted by the Bureau of Customs. That's already more than the country's total seizures for full year 2023, which was at nearly 27 billion pesos. And with the expected surge of counterfeit goods in the country these Burr months, the NCIPR vows to be more diligent in monitoring the market.
Counterfeiters have turned to more sophisticated methods in this digital age, with online platform becoming a primary battleground for IPR violation. We will explore and adopt advanced technologies such as artificial intelligence, data analytics, and blockchain to improve our monitoring and detection capabilities.
According to the Intellectual Property Office of the Philippines, 60% of seized fake goods are different types of apparel, like shoes, bags, clothes, and eyewear, followed by perfume and beauty products, gadgets, and cigarettes.
Sa mga ating pong mga kababayan, nakikiusap lang po kami na gawin nyo na lang pong parigalo yung mga local products natin, di ba? Huwag na po yung mga fake na mga products sapagkat nawawalan po ng mga trabaho ang ating mga negosyo kung pagpapatuloy po natin yung pagbili ng mga fake products. Nawawalan po ng kita ng gobyerno na magagamit po sa pangkalusugan, infrastructure. Tingin po naman din namin, ayaw din po naman ninyo na mabigyan kayo ng regalo na fake, di ba? Na hindi assured yung quality.
The Department of Justice, meanwhile, encourages more brand owners to come forward and pursue legal action against those behind intellectual property rights violations.
We are very diligent in monitoring the market and doing inspections. However, the enforcement aspect will always need the cooperation of the brand owners. So as long as we do our work, but the brand owners will desist on pursuing their criminal actions and even their administrative actions, this is just a vicious cycle that we have to contend with.
Andres also expects the Philippines to be removed from the Financial Action Task Force's gray list soon because of the government's work in addressing issues such as intellectual property violations linked to money laundering activities.
One of the deliverables is intellectual property rights violations on money laundering, and we are very confident that when the FATF gray list matter is taken up this October, it is very possible that the Philippines will already exit the gray list.
Andres added that the government has also delivered on the FATF's other concerns, such as terrorism financing and cross-border cases. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
The Asian Development Bank sees the economy of Asia and the Pacific region growing more than initially expected. This, driven by solid domestic demand and continued strength in exports. It projects the region's growth this year at 5%, slightly higher than the 4.9% forecast in April. For next year, ADB maintains its economic outlook at 4.9%. The Manila-based lender, however, warns of potential risks to this outlook, including worsening trade tensions between the U.S. and China, as well as geopolitical tensions. Inflation in the region is expected to ease further to 2.8% this year, down from the previous forecast of 3.2%. But for 2025, ADB anticipates a slight acceleration in consumer prices. Meanwhile, the ADB is keeping its 6% growth forecast for the Philippines, citing moderating inflation, monetary easing, and sustained public spending. The Metropolitan Manila Development Authority is considering building an underground tunnel along Commonwealth Avenue to help alleviate the worsening traffic in the area. The road is notorious for horrific traffic and accidents. In addition to the tunnel, the agency is exploring the possibility of implementing a bus carousel system similar to the bus system with a dedicated lane currently in place on EDSA. The MMDA also noted delays in the construction of the MRT-7 along Commonwealth Avenue have further aggravated traffic congestion. The Commission on Elections has begun preparations for a special venue where candidates will file their certificates of candidacy for national positions in next year's elections, Sherian Torres reports.
These 2,400 square meter wide Manila Hotel Tent City, which can house 1,800 guests, will be transformed as the Commission on Elections filing venue for certificates of candidacy for the 2025 midterm polls. It will accommodate candidates for the Senate and party list seats. This early, the Commission on Elections has advised aspirants not to turn the proceedings into a festival by bringing their supporters. Those running for the House of Representatives and local positions can file their COCs in local COMELEC offices.
Kaya nga po kami nagkaroon ng limitasyon na tatlong pwedeng isama ng isang nagpa-file ng candidacy. Sana po sundin. Sapagkat mahirap po makipagmatigasan o kaya pag pinanindigan namin na talagang ito lang ang pwedeng pumasok, magkakapahiyaan pa lang po tayo. So sa para po maiwasan yon, piliin na lang po kung sinong pwedeng isama. Ang purpose po natin dito, gawing orderly ang filing ng certificates of candidacy.
These rules also cover incumbent government officials.
Kasi kapag po tayo ay nagiging flexible, masisisi po tayo ng iba na sumusunod. Isa lang ang sasabihin nila bakit ganito, bakit ganyan. Yan po ay applicable to all. And therefore, wala naman po exemption tayo dyan at wala tayong igagawa ng exemption para dyan. Ano man po ang kalagayan, katayuan nung mismo magpa-file ng incumbent man o hindi. Ito po ay para sa atin lahat.
The COMELEC, however, notes candidates can conduct any activities outside the filing venue. While Garcia admits they can't prohibit candidates from early campaigning using various methods to appeal to voters, the poll chief calls on the public to be more discerning.
Ngayon pa nga lang, meron ang lumalabas sa TV na mga ads, meron ang pagkalalaking mga tarpaulin na nasa mga kalsada natin, hindi po namin kayang pigilan. Pero siyempre, ang mga mamamayan na lang ang bahala kung sa kanilang palagay ay tama ba yung ginagawa ng mga ilang possible na kakandidato.
The Supreme Court, in its Piñera versus COMELEC case ruling, stated that political hopefuls, even those who have filed their COCs, can only be considered an official candidate on February 11th for national positions and March 28th if seeking a local seat. Meantime, two giant printing machines tasked to print 73 million ballots for the 2025 polls are now with the National Printing Office. 70 million votes will be printed for the national and local elections in May. 2 million will be used for the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao elections. And another 1 million as test ballots for the COMELEC's automated counting machines demonstration.
In the extreme na may ganun pa rin na problema, since bago nga, meron naman kaming mga contingencies. Of course, this is a ballot printing. Hindi naman namin basta po pwedeng isugal na umaasa lang kami rito. We have contingencies with the COMELEC.
Instead na apat na makina, dalawang makina na lang, kasi itong makina na to, kaya niya mag-produce ng up to 62 million pages per month ng letter size na balota.
The NPO will start printing the ballots in December until March of 2025. The COMELEC says it will double up the security at the NPO to protect the ballots. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.